Jericho challenging William Regal for the European title. And the, it's the Big Red Machine. Kane shoving Regal out of the way and going right to Chris Jericho. Oh my God, a one-arm touchslam. Chris Jericho inadvertently, accidentally spill hot coffee on Kane.
Oh, God. Sorry, champ. I hope that coffee didn't burn you. I mean, burn me.
Those drastic measures there for a spill, wouldn't you think?
I would think so.
If the walls of Jericho are locked in, we've got a new champion turn. Angle's gonna tap out.
Hey, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. It's Kane. Kane on the top rope.
1-2-J.
Kane from behind, clobbering Chris Jericho.
Kane's got a hot coffee complex. Oh!
Choke slam. Kane, all this over a cup of spilled coffee?
This all seemingly began over a cup of coffee.
You think this is about coffee? You want to see what lies under this? You want to see Chris Jericho? Well, the more you cheer for him, the more I hate him. The more you want to see him, the more I want to end him. After I beat Blackman and become hardcore champion, I'll challenge Jericho to a title defense. Then when I tear his face apart, when I rip out his pretty blonde hair, when I beat him so bad that his appearance is so repulsive that he too wears a mask as a shield, when I do that, it'll all be legal.
Hey, wait a minute. There's Jericho.
What the heck?
Jericho with a steel chair.
Oh, my gosh.
Knocking the steps right back on the face of Kane.
That man decapitated Kane. Did you see that?
Jericho showing no fear, knowing what the Big Red Machine wants to do to the handsome young man.
But Jericho, do you know what you've done?
Kane, I must admit I was relieved when I found out that your problem with me did not revolve around a cup of coffee. But when I heard your real reason, it really perplexed me. Let me get this straight. You're jealous because you think Y2J is one of the pretty people.
What he said.
Well, first of all, it's a little bit unsettling to find out that a 7-foot-tall, 350-pound grown man finds me to be pretty.
Uh-oh. Don't go there.
And second of all, Kane, have you seen these sideburns? There's nothing pretty about these monstrosities. But don't get me wrong. I guess I could be considered a halfway decent-looking guy.
Well, these girls think so.
But quite honestly, Kane, I think you're selling yourself short. I mean, I think your look, the Kane look, could blaze a fashion trend across this entire nation. I mean, I think it could be huge.
The Kane look? What's
so what
about?
I have done is I have taken the liberty to show you just how pretty you can be. So if you're watching, check this out.
What's he talking about, the Kane look? Hey!
Okay, look at this male model. I guess you consider him to be one of the beautiful people. But how much more beautiful would he become if he adopted the Kane?
Oh, no.
I don't know how wise this is.
Or take our two presidential candidates.
Christian Gore?
I mean, both of them colorless, both of them dull, but if you give them the cane, then we've got a political party that every Jericho-holic would like to attend.
Oh, man.
But you see, this just doesn't apply to guys. I mean, it applies to girls, too. Take Britney Spears, for example.
Oh, yeah. I'll take Britney Spears. Woo-hoo. She's a hottie.
I mean, she's gorgeous. She's one of the beautiful people.
Uh-huh.
But how much more beautiful would she be if she adopted the look?
No. No, I don't know. I don't agree with that.
I mean, think about it. She could call her next hit, Oops, I Did It, Kane.
What? Did it a cane? Oh, man.
And this also applies to images from the past. I mean, how much more revered and priceless would a classic masterpiece like the Mona Lisa become if it became the Cana Lisa?
The Cana Lisa? Jay's burying himself.
Yeah.
You see, Junior, what I'm trying to tell you is if you had a little self-confidence in yourself, you too could be pretty. I mean, you could become the sexiest man in America.
Kane?
And believe me, that would make everybody happy.
It's dead sexy.
Because I know, Kane, we all have our pretty side, but we all also have our ugly side as well. And I know that you are more than just an ugly, disfigured face. I mean, deep down inside, you are an ugly, disfigured, unforgiving, unrelenting monster. But I have to warn you, Y2J also has an ugly side.
Uh-oh.
Y2J also has a disfigured side. Because believe me, Jerky, there's nothing pretty about trying to decapitate you with a set of steel steps. Ooh, and there is nothing pretty about enjoying it so much that I want to do it again and over 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 and over.
It's an ugly side.
So tonight, after I beat you and The Undertaker and Chris Benoit and I become the number one contender for the World Wrestling Federation Championship, we can go in the back.
Uh-oh.
We can relax. And we can exchange beauty tips, because believe me, when this is done, you will never. I said you will never. Ever be the same again.
While the mind games begin for Chris Jericho, poking fun at the Monster Cat.